And so we know that Fatima was honored. And one of the narrations is coming from who? Umm al-Mu'mineen, Aisha radiallahu anha. She says, for example, she said, I used to look upon Fatima. And by Allah, the way she walked was the way the Prophet of Allah walked. And that her speaking was only like the speaking of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That the way the Prophet is the way that Fatima is. And then she says,
she says that anytime she entered upon a room where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was, she said the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would get up. He would greet her. He would kiss her. He would hold her hand, and then he would take Fatima and sit her down in the same place that he was sitting, alayhi salatu wasalam, honoring her and holding her in that high esteem. And you might think to yourself, subhanAllah, this woman is the daughter of Khadija radiallahu anha. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam said that Fatima is Sayyidatu Nisa al-Jannah. She is the queen. She is the leader of the women of paradise. Not only has she perfected her faith, she is the leader of the people of paradise.
Fatima, her hands were ripped apart. This is the daughter of the Prophet Muhammad. Her hands became harsh, became coarse, became rough, because she would knead the dough, wash the clothing, take care of the home. So she said one day to Ali, go and speak to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We've just received the booty, some servants have come, go and ask him to send a servant into our house to help us inside the house. Ali comes and he expresses his concern. The Prophet Muhammad listens to him. In the evening, he comes to visit both of them. He comes and he sits so close to them. They feel the body heat of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They want to sit up. Out of respect, he tells them to stay there. He says, don't think I am unaware of what you requested. He could have given it to them, as many servants as they wanted. He said to them, it's better for you every night to say Subhanallah 33 times, Alhamdulillah 33 times, Allahu Akbar 34 times. That's enough. You don't need these elements of the dunya. And he says, I never gave that up in my life. Never. When I fought, when I struggled, turmoils, calamities, difficulties, I went to sleep saying Subhanallah 33 times, Alhamdulillah 33 times, Allahu Akbar 34 times. Indeed, the dhikr of Allah, do hearts find tranquility and find peace.
She was young when the Prophet of Allah came towards the end of his life, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And that was a very difficult moment for Fatima. And we know, for example, during the illness of her father, Fatima exclaimed and says, oh, what grief there is. And the Prophet says to Fatima, your father would have no grief after today. Your father will have no grief after today. I mean, indicating to her that he would pass away, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha, she sees the Prophet in his battered state, in his clothes and his illness, and she starts to cry. And Rasulullah calls her over compassionately. And the Prophet says, come, let me tell you something. And Rasulullah whispers something to her. And she starts to cry further. And Rasulullah says, come back down. Let me tell you something else. Come back. And he whispers to her again. And she starts to laugh. And the people were amazed. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha demanded, she said, tell me what it was that the Prophet told you. And at first she refused, but eventually she gave in and she told Aisha radiallahu anha, she said that my father told me the first time, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he would not survive this illness. And then he called me back and he told me, you will be the first one to join me. She laughed at death. The Prophet ﷺ was telling her, you're going to be the first one to die from my companions. And subhanAllah, 4 to 6 months afterwards, Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha becomes ill. And actually she was ill from the time of the death of the Prophet ﷺ out of her pain from her father dying. And this is a mother of young children. This is a mother who's married to a wonderful husband, but she just wants to be with her father sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Jannat al-Firdaus. She says that whenever you do my ghusl and whenever you do my janazah, do it at night so that the people will not see my figure. SubhanAllah, this was a woman who was full of modesty. She's the daughter of the most modest, the most bashful, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So she said, whenever you bury me, bury me in the evening so that no one would see my figure. SubhanAllah. And that is how she was buried at night. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala joined her with her father sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and she took her rightful position as the queen, the leader of the women of paradise.